Oh, no, I don't need you. Oh, start sharing. Okay. Everyone, I'm a little early. I thought I'd get started. I won't actually start the video to playing the episode until others join us, but yeah, so there. I'm just seeing if it works here on my phone. I'm logging an upcoming event. Beginning, huh? Anyway, I've got a few things I gotta get done before I can upload a video, so I thought I'd do that with you while wait for this be to begin. I guess it's still saying I'm gonna begin in 8 minutes. Well, whatever. Okay, so bad. Well, hopefully that'll smooth up. You know what? It might be because over here I'm encoding an episode and I'm cleaning some other things. Yes, that's no, that's crap. Yeah. Anyway, maybe I'll pause that. In fact, you know what? I will pause that because oops, where is it? Pause, minimize, because it's slowing down the processor on my computer. One of the things I need to do though is so here's the episode I'm going to be debuting to you guys right now. And one of the things I like to do with these episodes before I do it is I want to put up a negative title card there that says, and thank you to all the patrons of that month. So hang on, wait, where is it now? Nope, that's not at all what you need. Here we are. So this episode. Oh, okay. It was March 2016. So the patrons of March 2016 are who funded this episode. Thank you very much, March 2016 patrons. And now I'm going to open up After Effects, and then I'll just create an extra little title card there that we're going to throw in that says thanks to all the others, because we list all these people, and I want to make sure we give thanks to everyone. Okay, so my titles are opening. My other screen, I'll move it over here as soon as the thing is open. Converted. Oh, because it's old. I guess, okay, so I'll change that to 2017. Okay, so here we are. Let's go to workspace single screen. Where's my, I don't have a stand. Okay, I'll just do standard. There we go. Okay. So what I want to do is find, oh boy, my computer's running really slowly. I wonder if that means that this isn't, that you're not streaming very well, that you might be getting a shoddy connection. According to this, I haven't started. Oh, can I press play? Yeah, there I am. I'm playing. Okay. So 13 of you are watching with me. Who is watching? Who's with me? I just remembered. I always like to have open up a chat window. There we are. Oh, good. People are chatting already. I usually do this before I start. Hey everyone. Where is everyone watching from? Cool. Okay. Answer me. Meanwhile, I'll get back to this because I need to create, I guess I'll go to the, I'll do this, I'll duplicate this page, and I'm just going to renumber this as 680 patrons of March 2016, 417. Okay, here we are. I don't need you. So I'm just going to delete that. I'm going to move this down. And what, okay, hang on. So I made a note to myself how that's supposed to be worded exactly. And that is, and all the other. Okay. And I want a big, I'll just grab that copy right here, paste. So funny. Okay. This all makes sense what I'm doing in a moment. And thanks to all the other March 2016 patrons. There we go. And let's bring that up. I'll bring you down. And There we go. Okay, that's pretty good. So now what I need to do is, squish this down. I'm going to drag this into here. Where are all my credits? There it is. So I'm going to drag this into credits. I can minimize you. Failed to connect to the Adobe. Crying out loud. I wonder why. I wonder if it's because it's a different version or something. Hey, let's save. Now let's try. Ah, okay. Yeah, I had to click save. Good. Now I will grab. And this I will change to my single screen edit. Boop. There we go. And I'm just going to move me over. Actually, you know what? I'll just make me really tiny. And drag that over. And you. And then the title I just dropped made is this one. And I just want the picture. I'm going to drop you in like that. There we go. Okay, great. Good. So now all I need to do is hit export. Some material is offline. Oh, crap. What's offline? Are you offline? No? Oh, but you're small. Oh, I know why. It's because it's grabbing from... Is it grabbing from... Whatever, I'll finish this later. So once we're done doing this live stream, I will then tailor this and upload it to YouTube and to Daily Motion. So like you'll actually get the link later today after we do the live stream. Because actually, it's not a good idea for me to upload while we're doing this anyway. So there. Anyway, so I'll just minimize that. Actually, I'll just hit save. So let's see what people are saying. Oh, lots of people are talking. We got people from the UK, from Brazil. I'm in chemistry class. Watch this. What are you doing watching this? You should be paying attention to chemistry class. That's hilarious. Argentina, Denmark, California, Panama, CT. Is that Connecticut? Chile, Washington State, Mexico, Luxembourg, Spain. You're visiting from Hello All. I've been watching for years already. Oh, that's great, Lucy. Lucy, thank you. I'm a big fan of Out With Dad. I've watched all the episodes in 3 days or less. That's awesome. When did you discover the show? I'm just going to give you sort of a warm up. It's 2 o'clock now. I guess it's time that we can officially start. Is it 2 o'clock? Well, actually, you know what? It's not 2 o'clock. I guess that clock is late. This one says it is 2 minutes to 2. So we'll wait until about 2 o'clock before we actually show the episode. But what I thought I'd ask you guys is, you know, what questions do you want to ask me? And maybe I can answer them while we're waiting for 2 o'clock to actually come along, because I don't want to start early. That would be very unfortunate for those who are tuning in at 2 o'clock. But yeah, please ask away, ask questions. Maybe I'll type that too. What questions have you got for me today? Fire away, please. Cool. So lately I've been doing a lot of editing. A lot of the corporate business work has been catching up for me lately. I've been really what's that? I'm actually from Reunion Island. But yeah, so I've been doing a lot of corporate work, and that's actually been getting a lot busier and busier for me lately, which is good news. It's not the dream job, but it's a good job. And so what I've been doing is, because I don't know how busy I'm going to be getting later this year, I've been trying to get as much work done ahead of time. So we're into season 5 now, and actually just before we started doing this, I was working on episode 505 actually. So I'm like, it's still super rough, but I'm like halfway through. So I've been getting a ton done. And last night, I think it was, or the night before, I posted Why don't you put that on? Oh, that's the reminder. It's 2 o'clock. It's time to start this podcast, this live stream. Now I'll put this on silence until my next alarm. There you go. Okay, good. Sorry, I'm distracted. Where was I? Yes. A few nights ago, I uploaded episode 503 to the patrons of Our Dad. Not to all of them. So one of the perks is if you're a donor of $5 or more, then you get to see rough cuts. So I uploaded a rough cut, and I've been sort of holding off on that because I actually finished that first rough cut in I think it was in December actually, and but there's one scene in there that it was really crucial that the music was right. So I didn't want to share that episode without music because Adrian hadn't had a chance to see it yet or work on it. So I asked him if he would mind taking a look at that. And what's interesting is one of my favorite things to do, one of my favorite steps of the whole filmmaking process is that moment that I get that email from Adrian, and he's usually got an MP3 in there, and I get to drop that MP3 file right into my timeline. So not you, but so like down here, so it'll be like a file like this that I just drop in there, and then presto changeo, I have music. And it's like it's one of my favorite steps of the whole filmmaking process. I get such a thrill because I love film music, and Adrian knows this, so what I did is I actually filmed myself while I was dropping it in. So the patrons of Ed with Dad actually got to watch me and watch that episode for their first time with the music by Adrian Ellis. So that's kind of one of the cool perks. So if you are a patron of Evadad, $5 or more, you can see that video. So that's pretty cool. So who else is watching? Michelle is watching from Belgium, of course. Thank you, Michelle. It's good to see you. Hello from Peru. My teacher is trying to teach mole ratio, but I'm watching this. Yeah. I think I'd watch this instead of that too. How old am I? I am 39. Yeah, 39. I just have to think about that. Someone else is 17. Someone is watching from Spain. How did you get the inspiration to make out with Dad? I had a dream. So this dream, it was 8 years ago. This April, it'll be 8 years if you can believe it. And I had a dream that I was a dad and that I had a daughter. And from there, it just sort of like, it circled from there. And at some point I was thinking, what if she came out to me? And, so I started just thinking about that. And so that's kind of where the inspiration came from. That's the short version of that story. How many episodes have you recorded for the next months? Great question. Thank you for asking. So we have shot up to, hang on a second. Actually, I can show you this spreadsheet right here. This actually answers your question. So what we have done is in September and October, we shot all of these episodes right here. And so they are in the can. Now I've already released these two, and then like I mentioned, this one right here, which I don't want to share the title of it with you yet. That one is that's the one I shared the other night. I got a rough. Ooh, I can actually now type in this right here. Copy, paste, update my little thing there. So I've got a rough cut done of the first episode. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 episodes, although it's 6 months worth of budgeting, because the this episode right here, it's sort of a double whammy, and so we budgeted 2 months worth of our funding towards the one episode. Is kind of more or less how it worked out. So in March I'll release only the first half of the episode, but it's running my current cut, which is I just finished, it's about 12 and a half minutes, so that's actually pretty long for half. The second half, it might not be as long. It's probably going to be like maybe 5 or 6 minutes, something like that. But altogether, 505 is going to be pretty long. So that's the answer to that question. Someone's watching from Mexico. Oh, someone else is watching from Mexico. Guten Abend is clear to be... Oh, is clear. It's going to be in more episodes. So we filmed... So basically all of these episodes... episodes, these ones right here, like 416 to 422, these are the ones with Claire in them. And I haven't planned anything beyond 505. So I actually can't answer that question. She is currently filming. Actually, I don't know if I'm allowed to say what she's on right now, but she's shooting a really high profile TV show in Alberta right now. So congratulations, Caitlin. That's a pretty big deal. So I'm really, you know, we're all really excited and jealous for her because she's working with some amazing actors that I know I love. And so anyway, best of luck, Caitlin. What other questions have we got here? Without giving away any spoilers, that performance by you know who in 503 was mesmerizing. It really was. By both of them, wouldn't you say? from Connecticut, has Ed with Dad changed from the original idea, or has it become quite clear from the start how the storyline was going to go? Oh, fascinating question. You know what? It is very, very, very much like the original idea. In fact, actually, you know what? I want to share something with you. Hang on. I'm just going to open it up on this screen, and then I'll move it over. So I've got this document called Out with Campbell. Here it is. Let me just resize it because there's some confidential stuff in there, so I just don't want to share that with you, all of it. Here we go. Okay, so I'll move this over. So here is the story beats. So have you ever heard of Joseph Campbell? Joseph Campbell is this guy who basically broke apart and studied what it's called the hero's journey. And I'm giving the real concise version of this whole thing. But he basically says that in all stories, there's the following steps. There's the call to adventure. There's a refusal to call, supernatural aid, and so on and so forth, and so on and so forth. George Lucas, when he was writing Star Wars, he was mesmerized by Joseph Campbell. And so he actually pretty much follow the Joseph Campbell thing tick by tick. He received Princess Leia's message, Luke, this is following Luke's story, must help with the harvest, so he refuses the call, but then he ends up going, he meets all these supernatural things, he escapes from, you know, so all these steps that happen in Star Wars, and then when you actually look at The Matrix, it's the same exact thing, you know, like, you know, he's like, no, I won't climb out the window, and so forth. So I was really fascinated by that, and so I started inserting my story into this, so when you look at this, like, it's changed a little bit. Oh, this actually, what's interesting there, it says Rick, that actually becomes Kenny later, you know, and so I wrote all of this before I wrote most of the show. In fact, actually, somewhere in here, it actually says, something about a musical number. Here we go, musical number, which I guess is equates to Luke becoming a Jedi and Neo discovering that he's the one. So like, and then they get to go to the dance. Well, so, I mean, there are obviously differences, like, cause there's no way we could afford a dance and, you know, so like, anyway, so this is kind of an interesting thing. So I don't know, like the end here, like, I guess it's changing from the end. So I don't know. So there. So that's kind of part of my, you know, that's my long-winded answer to you, where you asked, has it changed much? And the answer is not that much. It's actually pretty close. I mean, I made one big decision that differed in season, because like season 4/5, I was never sure I was going to do that. And so I'm doing things that I guess 4 and 5 is quite different than like what was in that document, because this actually ends. Oh, where is it again? Here it is. This actually ends at season 3. Friendsgiving. Oh, fascinating. I had Friendsgiving in here. Wow. You know, I didn't know about this. Chooses to be with Vanessa, not knowing she's leaving Dad behind in the dust. Okay. So yeah, things have changed. That is so crazy. Because I think the barbecue to Rose, the magical flight, this is the end of season 3 right here, and that's where I was going to end it. And so I don't think I ever had any intentions of doing any of this. I'd forgotten I wrote Friendsgiving Fiasco, because I actually did do Friendsgiving Fiasco in season 4. So I guess some of this is in there. Finally has the confidence to be an out woman, reconciles with Claire. Wow. But actually, we do reconciling with not with Vanessa, but she does it with Claire. So I guess, yeah, things have changed, obviously. But, isn't that interesting? I'm glad you asked me that. Thank you. I finally figured I had to come onto the chat. Oh, good. I'm glad that you've joined us, Luna. Are the episodes after 505 scripted? No, not yet. In fact, I haven't had the time to even, like, think about it. So, hi from Germany. Is she going to be in Fargo? Well, there you go. I guess I'm allowed to tell you. Yeah, so she's shooting Fargo season 3 right now. Isn't that crazy? Says, good evening from Germany. Guten Abend. How is my pronunciation? Hey, from the Netherlands. Oh, hey, I'm from Norway. Ha det godt. I know that's more of a goodbye thing. One of my closest friends lives in Norway, so I've learned, you know, a little bit of Norwegian talk. Now that the end of 503 has happened, I wonder what's going to happen next. I'm sure a lot of people are wondering what's going to be next. Did you think about the end of the series? It's difficult to stop something you like to do. I don't want to think about it. No, I'm not going to. Nope, I'm not answering that question. I'm not thinking about that. I love Star Wars and The Matrix, so no wonder I love that with Dad. Well, you know, if you think about a lot of adventure stories, you'll find that there's that those 13 steps are common in so many stories. I'm sure, you know, even I bet you could do the same, like Wizard of Oz is probably fits that mold. You know, what else? I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, you look at Iron Man's story is probably the same. It's so common. It is so common, that whole, the theory of the hero's journey. It's a fast, there's a whole, he wrote a whole book about it. And I know myself that one of the reasons I had to, like, resize this is because in the next columns over that I don't want to share with you, I have, I've been working on other shows and other story ideas, and so I don't want to share those with you, but I often come back to this spreadsheet and I just start plugging in ideas. And I know myself, like, when I was first writing it with Dad, you know, I was writing it in no particular order. In fact, I didn't even think I would be the writer. I thought I was going to hire a screenwriter. I'm glad I did. And, you know, like, I knew that I was going to have it come out to Dad. I knew I wanted to have some, like, big thing with her, with Vanessa's parents and all this kind of stuff. I knew I wanted to do a thing about a sleepover. So I knew these scenes that I wrote, but then I had, like, a lot of empty holes. And I found that when I had the empty holes, I was able to then, like, realize, like, oh, I need something to connect here. Like, it's like, oh, I need to consult a gay friend or Rick. I wonder if Rick is actually Johnny, not Kenny. No, I bet you Dad consults. Yeah, no, that's Dad consulting Johnny. That's episode 102. Rose comes out to Rick. Well, that actually doesn't happen until 108. So yeah, oh, it's kind of fun for me to look back at this. That's so interesting. And I tried to do, actually, notice with the slashes, I tried to make sure I had the hero's journey for both Rose and for Nathan. So they both have a hero's journey. I mean, in the end, you'll see that the story really started focusing more just on Rose. And, but then go figure, you know, then you get into Vanessa's story and she too has a very similar, you know, she'll have her own hero's journey there. So anyway, I could talk about that stuff forever. So, so it is now, it's quarter after, we've been chatting a lot. So why don't we get to why you're welcome here? I'm going to share with you episode 417. Now this is, it's called session 52. And the idea is, the reason I started calling them sessions, you know, and the numbers, because the idea is, like, you know, like, I guess she's having a, she's having a, you know, a session once a week, basically. And the, you know, so, you know, she'll probably miss one or two here, but I thought 52, that's 52 weeks in a year. So this is roughly 1 year since she started. And so I don't know if, like, people, like, were doing the math, but I actually was doing a lot of math to, like, try and align things, because ultimately when we get to the more or less to the last Counselling Vanessa story, I want it to align in time with where things are in with Dad. So that was kind of some of the thoughts there. So will there be more transgender people introduced in the show? Until now, it was just one female to male with a minor role. I'd love to include more transgender people. Actually, a friend of mine just came out as transgender, and I'm very, very, very excited for her. She's everything's been going really smooth for her too. Like just this week came out, so It's a I'm so excited for her. But I don't know if I like the thing is, like I said, I've been so focused on I've been trying to get other things off the ground, other projects off the ground. And I know, like in the show, But How Do You Have Sex, we absolutely wanted one of the main characters in that. It was going to be the three roommates. There was going to be the one character that Kate was going to play. I think her name was going to be April. And then Russell was going to play the other roommate. And his character was going to be straight identified, and he's a person with a disability. And the third roommate was the plan is to have that person as a transgender person, and who just doesn't have time for their bullshit. And so I'd still love to get that show going on, because you know it'll be such an interesting intersection of all these different kinds of people and that stuff. And also we get to be a lot more mature than we were with that with Dad. So will there be more introduced in Ed with Dad? I don't know, but certainly in future projects, I very much would like to do that. I'm a big fan of Ed with Dad. I watched all seasons in one day. I wonder how long is that, like that's like 9 or 10 hours, isn't it? I don't know how long. It's long. Anyway, I'm gonna close this window so I don't get distracted. Zoop, zoop. Okay. How about we watch the next the episode 417? So this is approximately a year into Vanessa's counseling, and I'll just shut up and we'll just press play. And then after we're done watching, we'll go right through to the end credits. Once we're done that, we can talk more. So here we go. Enjoy 417.
The series is funded by fans like you.
And you've been sleeping better too, haven't you?
Yeah, it's been better.
You must be pleased.
Yeah. Except last night. I get this weird rush before I come here. It's like I look forward to it all week and then I get scared. Like I get so anxious I can't sleep the night before.
Yeah, just so you know, that's really common. A lot of my clients tell me that they have this mix of excitement and dread about coming to their sessions.
Yeah. It's been like that ever since I told you about what happened. I get excited, but yeah, I'm like dreading it a little. It's not like I really like talking about it, but I do feel glad after we do.
Why do you think talking about it makes you feel glad?
Well, because then it's like out in the open. I don't have to be so careful.
Yeah, I can totally understand that. Does it, I don't know, help you give you some perspective too, perhaps?
Oh, definitely. And I keep remembering things, like, about it, that Kayla was there too. I'd totally forgotten.
Sorry, who's Kayla?
She's, like, this whole other story. She was there the night it happened. She was all strung out, and she didn't really do anything to help. And the night before, she, I guess I let her, but not like Kyle. He didn't give me the choice, but I don't know. Maybe that was my fault too. I just feel so stupid.
Why do you say that makes you feel stupid?
Because I stupidly went down there, even though I knew it was dangerous. I could have easily just turned around and walked away, but I didn't.
Okay, so why didn't you?
Well, because I was scared. I was frozen.
I can totally understand that. It sounds like such a scary situation you were in, Vanessa. Okay, what in particular was scary for you?
Well, I didn't know what would happen if I did anything.
So it sounds like you feared what might go wrong if you moved or did the wrong thing?
Yeah, but then I did nothing. I just stood there, and he came over to me, and he told me to sit on the couch, so I did.
Would you mind if we play devil's advocate for a bit? Why did you go to the couch?
Well, what do you mean, why? He was huge.
So still playing devil's advocate. You're telling me you found yourself in a really scary place with this huge guy. Who traps you and he's telling you what to do. You're alone. You're frightened, and you do it because you fear you have no choice.
Yeah.
So given all that, would you say your actions were stupid? I didn't think so. Vanessa, to me, it sounds like you were in a really tough situation and you made the best choice you could.
I guess I did get away eventually.
See, that's true. What is it?
He tried to give me this pill. He said it would make everything feel better, like all the rejection and anxiety would go away, and I felt like he really knew me. And for a second, I considered it.
Why does that seem important to you?
Because I almost caved. I knew it was stupid, but I just wanted to feel relief. I just feel so manipulated.
You sound really disappointed in yourself.
Yeah, I am.
You know, sometimes we look back at ourselves and as if we see that person as someone else, someone other than you. And we tend to judge the other person pretty harshly, don't we?
I guess. I just feel like the whole situation could have been avoided.
Okay, so Vanessa, imagine you had a friend describe everything you've told me you went through. Someone who was manipulated, who thought she'd walked into a situation that was so scary. Do you think you'd judge her so harshly?
No, I wouldn't.
What do you think you'd say to her?
I would try and tell her that it'll be all right.
That's very kind. What else?
I would tell her that she's not alone.
What would you say to her if she said she was stupid for getting herself into that situation? Do you think you condemn her?
No, I would tell her... I would tell her that it could have happened to anyone. I would tell her that it's not her fault.
Those are compassionate words.
Yeah.
So how about this? The next time you find you're being this hard on yourself, perhaps you should try to remember what you'd say if you're talking to a friend.
So with the delay, you're probably still watching. I'm watching the live stream too. So there. How amazing is Lindsay Middleton, eh? I think that was the episode where that was actually take number one, if you can believe it. I think that was the one that we did only one take. It was pretty incredible. I can remember myself when I was crying when we were filming it, and then after we finished filming it, Lindsay and Rose, not Rose as in the character Rose as in Rosanna Zammit, who is the counselor. The three of us we gathered around my camera and we were watching the playback on, you know, so it was like a little screen this big, and we were just like, yeah, that's the one. So some questions are coming up. Laura asks, do I need to prepare my tissue box for the next episodes? Oh, too late. Maybe you did just now. I'm not sure. There are definitely some more tearful moments up ahead. And also some really funny moments. In fact, I think it's the next episode, 418, is the... which one is that called? I got it right up here, don't I? Without Regret. Yeah, so Without Regret is a really long episode. It was merged into one, and that one there's got some really funny moments in that one, I think, especially the dealing with consequences part one and part two. Those are the Friendsgiving episodes, and there's some like hilarious moments in those there. So maybe a box of tissues, not just for crying, but maybe it's because of tears of hilariousness. I don't know. Michelle is asking about the future of Ephemeral Connections. So Ephemeral Connections, that's a web series project that I really want to get made. That's not necessarily a web series project. Maybe it's a television show. Maybe it's a feature film. It's kind of... anyway, the answer is I don't know. I haven't dropped it. Like, I've been thinking about that project for 4 or 5 years now, and it still speaks to me. So it's still something I want to make. And so at one time, Ephemeral Connections was going to be like the next season of It with Dad, but like it's not connected with Dad anymore. So we'll come around. Stay tuned, I guess, on that one. What I love about Lindsay's performances is her ability to draw you right in, her awareness and deftness of the light and the shade of the scene. She's brilliant, isn't she? I mean, absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. For 503, lots of tissues. Yeah, I got teary-eyed. 503, that's true. Feelers and thought without it being overblown. Laura, boxes and a tub of Ben and Jerry's. Yes, because L. Ann, she has seen those episodes. Applause from Filmmaker Dream. Thank you, Filmmaker Dream. Nice, but this belongs to the previous season. This episode, yeah, this episode is, because you've seen this episode, Luna, because you are, you've been watching. You're one of the champions of It with Dad, so you're all caught up, aren't you? But yeah, this one is me making it public for everyone right now. Julia, love you guys. Thank you, Julia. That's very nice of you. Jenny, Penny, any, many. I wish I could be a champion, but I can't. We wish you could too, but we understand. How many more of these are you going to do? How many more of these? As in, how many more these live streams? I don't know. It's funny because I've been wanting to do one of these for a long time, and I was even thinking about doing them like once a month. But like the last one, I think we did it was like, was it in October? And just, I don't know. Like, it's just like, I have to, be able to plan accordingly. I have to make sure that I, basically have the house to myself, because otherwise I don't want, because I'm in a basement. And so above me, I don't want my 3.5-year-old like running around, and I also have to not be working. It takes a lot for me to just get around to doing this, and I love doing it, and I think, and I gather you guys like doing it too. So I don't know. I guess the answer is I don't know. What I'd love to do is more of these with the cast, because I think that's even more fun when I'm joined by any of them. I would have loved to have had Lindsay, and actually, come to think of it, stupid me, I didn't even think to ask Lindsay, but I just know how insanely busy she is right now. If you go to her Facebook page or to her website, lindsaymiddleton.ca, or go to her Facebook page, you'll see that she's just insanely busy. She's got a play coming up. She's doing a fundraising project for Happy Her, because they're raising money for schools for children in Nepal. I think there's like 400 other things I'm not thinking of. So Lindsay is a really busy person. If you live in the Toronto area, make sure you follow her carefully, because you can always go see her in one of her plays. So that's a thing. There you go. You guys helped me out when I was coming out. I'm forever thankful. Oh, Julia, I'm so glad we could be there for you. I still remember our first table read. This is back in, this would be in like March 2010, thereabouts. And you know, so I didn't really know the cast yet. Like we were still like it was only like for that night. It was the first night that some of the cast had even met each other, you know. So hard to think about in a way because like now we're all such close friends, but you know, I could kind of, you know, I want to set the stage and set the tone that night. So before we started reading the scripts together, as we read all of season one together. And I told them, I said, you know, like the internet is a powerful thing and you know, we don't know, I don't know how successful this show will be or not. Like, I don't know if anyone will watch it, but you know, if we're lucky, someone will watch this and it will mean something to them and maybe we'll help them through a difficult time. And that was something we always hoped would happen, but we never, I don't know, it's like we all knew that that was possible, but we never believed that that would happen because it just seemed too unlikely, too big a deal. And go figure, here I am 7 years later. It's 8 years for me, this journey is 7 years since I met my cast and crew, my friends, my family. And here we are, and we're still making the show, and we've learned so many things about our audience. We've heard so many stories from you guys about how much the show has meant to you, and it's an incredible feeling. Like it's a really incredible feeling, and thank you. You know, yeah, you guys have. I mean, gosh, if that night you would have told me I'd still be making the show 7 years later, I don't think I would have believed you. I really don't think I would have believed you that we'd make 80 something episodes of this show. No way I would have believed you. So there, thanks for saying that. Hello from France. I totally missed most of this, but I love them too. The live streams are awesome. Good. I'm glad you think so, Helen. Hello, Helen. Robin says, so glad you are sharing these episodes publicly. We're in a, I mean, the thing is, we still haven't made it to our funding goal, and we're actually hovering at around 50%. So I think I'm not going to think about it right now because you know, because I'm focused on getting everything edited right now, and but I'm gonna have to, you know, take a step back and do some hard thinking about how do we move forward because we sort of plateaued at around $2,500, which you know is, you know, to be very frank, that's not enough to make a show. You know, and at the beginning of season four, I'm sure you all agree, the b beginning of season four wasn't great. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't great because, and that's because we were doing, you know, after the great success of season three, and that we actually got to pay everyone like almost appropriately, like it was less than minimum wage, but you know, we decided we're gonna at least do this at least minimum wage. In fact, I was aiming for $15 an hour was the minimum, which is what Ontarians are fighting for, and you know, we're hoping to move the minimum wage in Ontario to $15 an hour. So I said, well, if I want that, then I have to practice what I preach. So we all agreed we're not going to work for less than $15 an hour. And you know, and that meant putting huge limitations on the episodes that we made. And those limitations were things like, well, okay, we can only have two cast members and we can only have one location. So that means one scene. And we can really only do one setup. So we can have two cameras rolling. But that was it. Like that's all we could afford for one episode was two people talking in one location with, you know, for, you know, for 10 minutes or whatever. So like that's a whole day of work right there for that one scene. So like that's all we could afford. And we knew that season four wasn't as good in the beginning until we started, you know, the funding grew and we got to do more things. We got more creative, but you know, I don't know, got to think long and hard about how we carry on season five smartly with the kind of budget. Do we have to reevaluate our goals? Things like that. So lots to think about. That's for sure. No, the Vanessa ones. when will they be back on YouTube for free again? So yeah, so I don't know. I mean, like, you know, right now the goal is still to patreon.com/outwitdad. You know, the idea is that once we reach like once this number reaches where's the goals thing? They've changed this whole thing. Where's the goal? I don't get it. Anyway, somewhere here it says what our next milestone is. Why is it not saying that right here? For crying out loud, that's silly. I can't find it. Anyway, once we reach our next milestone, which is $5,000, I thought, anyway, whatever. oh, we're watching from Costa Rica. Great. Good that other people get to watch this. I would also probably rewatch the marathon later, maybe with my girlfriend when she comes over. Oh, someone's watching from Italia, from Italy. When do we see the episode? Oh, the 417 episode. Oh, sorry, Marie Julie. We already screened it, so you can always go back and watch it. It's in here. I'm gonna upload it like right after. So if you just want to wait, just I'll put it on the I'll put it on ebodad.com. I'm gonna put it on Daily Motion and YouTube and all that stuff. So or you could just scrub back to when this episode was happening. How has the creative landscape in Ontario changed since web series started? Fascinating question. And I mean, it's so crazy because it exploded and there were so many people making so many shows, but lately, not many people are making as many web series. And I think that's partly because everyone's realizing, I think we all entered into this with high hopes that we would be able to make our careers off of that, because you keep hearing about YouTubers making careers out of YouTube. But unfortunately, to make a web series, it's just not a sustainable model. Unless you do a show in the style of, say, the Lizzie Bennet Diaries or Carmilla, where it's like it's a direct to camera and you know, and then you can like bang off like 20 episodes in a day. And, you know, it's like that way, you know, you can publish several episodes a week, whereas the kind of show that I'm interested in making, and a lot of the filmmakers I know are interested in making, they don't want to make a direct-to-camera show. They want to make a full-fledged narrative story like what we're doing here with you know, with multiple cameras, well, multiple camera angles, locations, and so forth. So it's a different, you know, that kind of filming is quite popular because you can do so much, and it can almost fit into the YouTube model where you know, the ad dollars might actually be able to pay for it. Mind you, like Carmilla, like they got $1 or $2 million from Kotex to make that show. And, you know, but I've never seen that kind of money and I don't know how to get it. So, you know, I'd love it if we had sponsorship, but that's not, you know, and the ads from YouTube. In fact, I've often thought, should I just turn off the ads? Cause like I make almost barely anything from the ads on YouTube. So, and Daily Motion. So the landscape has changed. Like it was a big boom and then it sort of slowed down. And I think it's still slowing down. I think everyone wants to make web series because they like being their own boss and they like telling their own stories their own way. And they like being able to reach an audience. But I know a lot of people are now saying like, yeah, but it's too much work and not enough pay. And like, you know, people have to put food on the table. So hi guys, I'm from Ecuador. You're awesome. I hope Rose and Vanessa have a happy ending. All series, the lesbian couples have a bad final. Well, I don't like those bad finals either. 68 episodes plus 12 for the video diaries. Yeah, I'm counting the video diaries because it sounds better. Yeah, so it's 80. So I just published the 80th episode. Is that what you're saying? Wow. So that means we have 84, 85. So that means we have 82 episodes in the can. That's cool. That's really cool. Greetings from the Netherlands. Greetings back at you. If a friend became a champ, can you watch it if they give the log on there? I mean, I suppose so. I mean, you know, I'm just sharing the episodes with, I'm just sharing episodes. I don't know. I guess so. That's up to your friend. I'll answer it that way. oh no, my question was how many more episodes of the Counselling Vanessa ones? Oh, there are going to be more. Well, there's more. Yeah, there's one more that we've shot. And then we did a Counselling Dad episode. And because of course, you know this now that they're seeing the same counselor. so that's pretty cool. Wait, shoot. Am I talking about the right episode? No, I just totally gave a spoiler away. It's this episode. Oh, shit. Well, don't I feel sheepish? Sorry. This is the one you just watched. This is the one. Nothing. Pretend I didn't say that. Nope. Nothing. Nothing about Dad. All right. Where are we? Oh, message redacted. I wonder why. Oh, did you post it and delete it? I don't know what that means. Are you familiar with the Unsolicited Project on YouTube? Also, Unsolicited Project. Yes, I think I do. They're the ones that... yeah, they do a whole bunch of things with their channel. They're, aren't they the two girls that they did a... what was it called? The web series about the they're looking for they need to rent their place until least we part. Are they those ones that made that? I loved that web series. And I've met them. They're really really cool, and I love what they've done. They've really built themselves an empire. And they're doing a huge success. They've made some feature films. You know, I think that they nailed it. Really really great stuff that they're doing there. There is 422 and 423. Oh, there you go. Michelle answered. So thanks, Michelle. Except that he answered it better than I did because I just totally freaking nothing. Spoilers. I don't do spoilers. All right. So anyway, so what are we now? It is now almost, well, it's 22:03, and I have to go pick up my daughter now. She's at, we just started doing all day nursery school, so I can actually be able to do things like this. So unless there's any follow-up wrap-up questions, I should wrap things up right now. And what I will also get around to doing is I will finish this. Yeah, so actually this credit page right here, oh, where is it? 52. Yeah, so zoom in. I need to cut you and paste you right there. So I did that wrong. There we go. And paste. Oops. Paste there. Okay. So after I hit stop, I'm going to then export this video that has this extra, that title page. And yeah, so I'll export that and then I will upload it to YouTube pretty much promptly. And then you can watch the episode again there. When you do, please, you know, be sure you hit like, because if you do things like that, that helps, you know, boost, makes us look good, you know, according to the, you know, the Google robots and such. And yeah, so there. And then the, like I said, the next episode is, no, not you. Hang on a second, because the next episode, I'm just going to give you a little bit of a tease. The next at 4:19 is what I'm looking for. 4:17, 4:18 is what I'm looking for. I'm just looking at my computer here. 4:18 without regrets.
This year.
So yeah, I'm just gonna give you a little bit of a tease because I'm awful.
Freeze is funded by fans like you.
It picks up right where 4:16 left off. Oh, that's all I'm going to show you. So anyway, there you go. I love you guys. Thank you so much for... I mean, how many more until he stops making the Vanessa account? Yeah, so Vanessa, I don't... The answer is I don't know how many more because, like I said, I haven't thought beyond 505. So I do have great ideas, though, how to do it. They're really hard to write. They're really hard to write, those episodes. So that's one of the rings. So go have a great time with your kid, then. I absolutely will. Thanks, everyone. You guys are awesome. I enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed it, too. And we'll totally have to do another one soon. One last thing I want to mention. I want to go to Instagram out with Dad. One of the things I did, so some of you might have missed this, but I posted this picture on Instagram. I also posted it on Facebook. Where is it? How did I post it? Screw it. I'll just do that and then go back. Yeah, so I posted it on Facebook. So if you haven't liked us on Instagram and Facebook, What I did is I did this little challenge right here that I said, if this pic gets over 500 likes on Facebook and or Instagram, so I did it on both, then we'll do this. So the reason I'm doing this actually is in response to this challenge. So we'll do another challenge like this. That's Michelle right there. I totally know that. Thank you, Michelle. So we'll do it again. I did it once before when we did 416. In fact, I totally had some fun with it. So we did it there as well. So be sure you like us on Facebook and